How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to Let's Play Bloodborne the Old Hunters. We recently arrived here in the research hall, where we've been seeing a lot of gruesome stuff and digging real deep into more of the healing churches and Bergenworth's depravity. And I am looking and listening out for more of those pressure switches on the floor that trigger the exploding vials and beakers. They're everywhere in here. Oh, these ones are a lot more agile than the other ones we've been fighting. Maybe they're newer patients with a lot more vim and vigor. Oh shit, I can't even get a solid hit on it. Leap through the buzzsaw though. Yeah, these ones are just nuts. Oh, that mowed him down. That L2 on the whirly gig. Love it. Just soar through the sky. Acrobatic is what they are. But the buzzsaw locks them in place. Decorative old hunter garb. Yeah, let's check that out. Old hunter garb decorated with brass trinkets. At the time, some hunters believed that certain metals would ward off beast blood. On a night of the hunt, it's no wonder that people would resort to superstition. And that is a good looking set. That's a really good looking set, especially that hat. I wish it didn't look like I had this big tuft of blonde hair from the back of the mask, though. I love all these new wide brimmed hats they added. I also like learning about the lore. I know I forgot to trigger this elevator last time. It's a good thing I didn't die yet. Oh, and the mask looks terrific, too. Yeah, so this is actually the true shortcut from the bottom floor, but there's someone in here before we take the elevator back up to our hub room. And also, got like a pin cushion. Like I said, this door is our shortcut back from the first floor, so if we die and respawn at that lantern, we can just take the elevator right up and we're back up to the second floor. From here, we have easy access. Wait, no, this is the third floor that I think we go up to. So from here, we can actually get up to the fourth floor. Yeah, and we even triggered this elevator, which goes even further up. The research hall, hugely vertical level. It's really big. There's a broken staircase. We jumped down there last time. So I think I heard you this time. I think this is the one I got caught by before. So which route can I go from here? I think, because this leads back down to base level. Okay, so we finally completed this entire circuit. We've cleared out pretty much everything that we have left on the first and the second floor. So the only thing that we can do now is find a way to progress upwards. So we'll go back in this room, we'll climb the ladder again. I think there's another ladder or a set of stairs up here, and that will lead us out to the fourth floor. This is a little bit of a confusing area, but if you just let the level design here work its magic, you'll eventually find your way back to where you began. You'll kind of circle back on yourself. That's the kind of magical thing about this level design. It twists and it turns, but it always feeds back into itself, so it never truly gets lost. If you take a side path, you'll always work your way back around to the main path. If you miss a side path, the main path always kind of ends up in a shortcut that gives you easy access back to the side path so you miss. Oh, hey, ho, ho. Man, I can't believe I missed both of them. Let's get out of here. Let's let them come to me. I don't like what they're wielding. I can't quite tell what that is, though. I want to see. That's the crown and heads of conquered kings. Jackpot. Oh, that's all we came in here for. No, I think there's something that might want to ambush me on the way out. Unless I'm thinking of a different room. There is more here. Good. Dirty damn blood gem. This DLC. No, nothing dropped behind me. Okay, I am thinking of a different room. I've heard that this DLC is a good farming spot for gems if you don't feel like doing challenge dungeons. Let's see, there is a hunter down here who I want to sneak up on. What? Oh no, oh no, get out of my way. Get out of my way, big head fella. Okay, this is not how I imagine this going. No, I'm just gonna keep shooting. Yeah, do that. Go ahead. Just back up off that ledge. Okay. Yeah, you're a robin. I'm not Lady Maria. So you see we did a little bit of damage hitting her, and she appears to have died. And we'll examine the brain fluid we got from her. Grayish amoeba-shaped brain fluid, wobbles and bounces, extracted from a patient whose head expanded until that was all they were. Once a young girl had an older brother who was determined to become a doctor, and so she willfully became his patient. In the end, this led to their encounter with the Eldritch Truth, for which they considered themselves blessed. You can see that after hitting her, her health didn't go all the way down, and she eventually reformed herself, and she has the same dialogue as she ever did. But we do have her brain fluid, which, the patient strapped to the chair down there was asking for. The patient on the bottom floor, by the way, her name we'll learn later, is Lady Adeline. This elevator. Not terribly sure what the purpose of it is. We haven't triggered the elevator that passes by that little nook. But I'm not exactly sure what it's supposed to be used for. And I think pretty much completed everything I can on this path through. So I'm gonna drop down here and then we'll get back on the main path again. Since there's nothing for us to do but again keep ascending. Or keep finding a path to ascend. And we're back where we started the episode. This is the exact floor we started this episode out on. So once again, we will climb up here. This will lead us out to the hub room of the two elevators. And again, we're back on the main path. So yeah, there are tons and tons of ways to progress in this level, but eventually all roads lead back here. So we go down again, and then it was over here. I can't remember if there's actually a faster way to get up to where I was going without the shortcut elevator. But this is quick enough anyway. I'm gonna have to deal with a few of you. Could have gone the other way, I guess. Okay, that was kind of painless. I suspect, no! I thought I might get hit on the way up the elevator, but no, that was pretty good. So brain fluid. Brain fluid is an attempt at implanting eyes on the inside. Yosefka has some dialogue in the main game when you send patients to her that this time she's going to use just the old blood. And we know that her work was trying to ascend people and turn them into celestials, kings of the great ones. I'm going for again. So I'm thinking perhaps Yosefka was using brain fluid at first, and then she found that all of her experiments were failures. So this research hall might be more connected to Yosefka than I first let on. Also, we think that these headless ones, that their heads are some of the beings that we just encountered, the flip-flop on a robin guy. Or was he just decapitated? This room is entirely unpleasant. And yeah, you drop behind me. That's the one I was remembering earlier. Either way, it seems some of their enlarged heads have become loose. And depending on how sane they were, how recent the experimentations were, we can talk to some of them. It's actually kind of uncanny how many we've been able to speak to. Only one of them has been on a quest that we can do anything about, and that is Lady Adeline on the bottom floor. The flip-flop on the robin enlarged head can't really do anything with her except take her brain fluid. Which, let's see, we picked up this, an enlarged head of a patient at the cathedral, with a cavity that just happens to fit a human head, although one would be mad to try it on, but if you do, listen carefully, for the sticky sound drip-drop as water seeping up from the depths, slowly and steadily. I've never tried this before, but I want to try to keep this on and see if I get any dialogue out of some of these. I've never thought to try this before, but we know from experience that church attire changes the dialogue that you get out of a guy with a nun when you're in a Hypogean jail. Yeah, you see there's a little spot where you can jump off, and that's, I think, on the fourth floor that we saw earlier in that nook. So, I mean, yeah, like, I'm not really sure what the purpose of this is. Maybe it, I don't want to spoil that. Maybe it's for later. Maybe it's for later. I'll have to keep that in mind. Okay. Oh. How? My dude! Dude's grinding the fucking balcony on his wheelchair. Okay, where was I going? Back down here to get back on the main path again. Ah, there's you. Yeah, she didn't give me the dialogue. I hope one of them does. Right. Maybe I'll hear something unique. Something that I wouldn't normally hear with a head on. Again, pay attention to that new motif of sound. The sticky, splashing, dripping sound. The whole game has been about eyes and insight and eyes on the inside. But now we have this new motif in the DLC of sound, of trying to hear something. Something like the ocean. By the way, that's not entirely new, at least the ocean part of it. Remember the idea of sea as a bulwark from the deep sea rings. Yeah, so now we have just an easy way to get back up here now we've triggered this shortcut elevator. And I think we're almost done this half of the research hall. We don't want too much more to explore. That we come up these stairs, we come to a ladder, and then we get to the very top. This is technically the top floor, and we're going up to the rafters. Damn. I'm just fishing for it. Maybe I can... Nah. This one back is better. This one apparently has really high poise. They don't seem to behave any differently either, which is kind of disappointing. So, in lieu of that, I think I'm going to go back to one of my normal hats. Old hunter cap? Yeah, that's the way to go. This is a really badass piece of attire. And I love this view from up here. It's vertigo-inducing, man. Slowly just back on up. I'll take that hit. Sure, why not? Come to me. Come here, bro. In fact, come even back here. No? Okay. I would really rather not fight anything here. So this is an entirely different ladder. Leads up to a higher set of rafters. Oh, there are rats there, too. Just gonna try to take a pathway that avoids most enemies. So like the other, we are gonna attack this one and take her brain fluid. I find her dialogue curious and really disturbing in a way that I can't quite put my finger on. But that the flip-flop splish-splash stuff makes a little bit more sense now, doesn't it? I'm trying to figure out if I want to drop here or somewhere else. I think I might continue in a different way. Yeah. Actually, did that matter at all? No, I can totally get to something from here. What is that all about? there's a reveal coming up that I cannot wait for. I love that! Just swat him out of the air! It's the best feeling. I love the enemy type for that one reason alone. If the crows always try to jump at you like that, just smack him out of the air. Splish, splash, splish, splash. I can't wait. And now here's kind of our Duke's Archives moment. Of changing the configuration of all the staircases, except we're not flipping any or rotating any, we're just raising all of them up one level. So now the broken staircase will actually lead to that one giant set of doors, and we get access to a couple new things as well. So that's half of the research hall effectively finished. A little bit more than half. Actually, much more. So next time, we will finish Adeline's quest, and we will fight two bosses. One of which is one of the coolest bosses in the entire game. Thanks for watching, everyone. Take it easy, have a good one.